Today we're going to talk about the Big Tree Tech SKR E3-Dip version 1.0. Now this is a unique board in that it has several unique features such as our steppers. You can use multiple types of stepper driver boards for this, such as SPI, UART, and then the normal type of steppers. So let me explain the board a little bit. This is the x-axis, this is the y-axis, this is the z-axis, and this is E0. This is our processor right here. It's 32-bit. And then over here we have our input power. This is either 12 or 24 volts. But for the tutorials, I'll be doing 12 volts. Over here, we have a fuse. You can change this if an error occurs where you blow the fuse rather than replacing the board. Then we have our out power over here, which is either 12 or 24 volts. We have our bed power over here. Then we have our extruder power here. Over here, we have two sets of fan ports that we can run fans off the board natively. Over here we have our BL touch ports. So this port's for a servo and this port will be for your Y min. Over here we have our normal end stops. So we have our X minimum, our Y minimum, and our Z minimum. This is our thermistor for our heat bed, and then we have our thermistor over here for our extruder. Here we have a port for our TFT display, so it's a touchscreen display that you can use, and then we have a normal display port right here. Over here we have our serial peripheral interface pins, our USB port, and then our micro SD card. Now, in order to use this board, normally you're going to be placing these cooling fins on each one of your chips. So I'll let you figure that out via the directions. Excuse me. But for now, I'm going to show you how to load the firmware. So we're going to pop out the SD or micro SD drive and put it into the adapter. We're then going to place this into the computer and you may hear a beep. And just a reminder, all the materials used in this tutorial I purchased with my own money, and no one's sponsoring me or has asked me to do the video for money for them. So, in order for you to be helped out as to where to find this board though, I will be putting Amazon affiliate links within the description. To start with, I want to show you the SD card. First of all, it has firmware on it by default in all capital letters, and it's a cursor type file, so it has an extension of .cur. Now, the next thing I want to do is show you Atom with PlatformIO loaded on it. So in order to set this up, what you need to do is you need to download the Marlin-Bugfix-2.0.x from the Marlin Firmware website that I'll leave a link in the description for. Next, you're going to need to unzip it or extract it. And then you're going to go to File, Open Folder, and you're going to open up the Marlin folder. Now, inside here, I want to show you a couple things. First of all, we need to go to Marlin, Source, Core, then Boards.h. And in boards.h, we're going to do a search on DIP. And as you can see, we have the board right here, which is board underscore big tree underscore SKR underscore E3 underscore DIP. We're going to copy that. We're going to close out of boards.h. And I'm going to show you something unique here. We're going to go to the pins folder. And we're going to scroll down and we're going to open up the STM32. Which is the chipset that we're using. And we're going to find our board, which is in here as pins underscore big tree underscore SKR underscore E3 underscore dip dot H. We're going to open that up. And in here, you can see where our pins are associated to for our individual devices. In this case, I'm going to show you a real simple one. It's our end stop switches. And for our X minimum, our Y minimum, and our Z minimum, here are the pins that are associated with the signal pin. And this happens throughout the file to define where everything is. So I'm going to close out of that. Now I'm going to close these folders down so it's easier to read. So I'm going to go to configuration.h. In here is about 90% of your configuration, but I'm going to show you a simple way to do just your firmware for now. So we're going to do a search on motherboard, and we're going to highlight board underscore ramps underscore 14 underscore EFB. We're going to paste what we copied. Next, what we're going to do is we're going to scroll up to where it says define serial port, and we're going to change that to a negative one. And I want to show you one last thing, so I'm going to search on end stop. And in order to confirm our build, I'm going to go down here and I'm going to change our X minimum end stop inverting from false to true. And then finally, we're going to go over to the PlatformIO.ini. This is our configuration for our compile. So as you can see right now, our default environment is for the Mega AT Mega 2560. So we're going to do a search on DIP, and we're going to find our board type, which is just below the search, which is right here for our chipset. We're going to copy that, and then we're going to go back up to our default environment, and we're going to highlight it, and we're going to paste what we just copied so that it's our default environment right here. Next, we're going to click on the checkbox and save in order to let it compile. So we'll have our firmware.bin file, hopefully. Okay, now that we know the build is completed, we need to see if it's okay. So I'm going to click on PlatformIO, and I'm going to go to Toggle Build Panel. Inside here, it says there was one that succeeded, so we can scroll up to check it. So as you can see, our chipset was successful. So to close this down, we're going to say platform for PlatformIO and then toggle build panel again. Now in order to get the build and put it on our micro SD drive, we need to go to the .pio folder, then the build subfolder, and then inside this STM32, we're going to have to open it as an explorer. So hang on a second here. So open or show in explorer. And what we have here is the explorer folder. So I'm going to expand this out. I'm going to open this up. Inside here, there's firmware.bin. We want to send this to our SD card. So we're going to right click. We're going to do send to SD card. Now to check it, we can click on the SD card, and as you can see, we now have firmware.bin. Okay, in order to load the firmware, we need to remove the SD card, take it out of the adapter so that we can plug in the micro SD. We've done that. Next, we need to connect our USB cable. We're going to place this in here. We're going to place the other end into our computer, and you'll probably hear a beep. And as you can see, it's loading the firmware over here with the blinking light. So to test this, what we need to do is connect via Pronterface. Okay, now that we have the firmware installed on the Big Tree Tech SKR E3 Dip version 1.0, we're going to test it in Pronterface. So I'm in the Pronterface folder for print run. I'm going to open up Pronterface. And as you can see, the port is already selected for us because it's still connected. And the speed is defaulted to 250,000 bits per second. So I'm going to click on the connect button. As you can see now, it says that it's connecting and that the printer is now online. So to confirm that we actually loaded something on the actual board for the 3D printer, what we're going to do is we're going to type the G code M119, press enter. And as you can see, that modification that we did to the logic for the X minimum is now saying open, whereas the other two are saying triggered. So if you like my tutorial, please press the like button and subscribe. And thank you for your time.